much. We can hardly wait to see your faces. Joanna, did you hear that?
Yes.
Hang on, guys. There is something going on, and I need to check out what is happening here. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. What is going on here?
Hey, who's she?
I'm sorry.
Who are you?
I'm Camille Garcia. I'm supposed to be here. Who are y'all?
I am Gladys Fiona Rosero Laverne, Hemingway Bingley III. Thank you very much. I am on my mother's side, a Tyrannosaurus Rex Amoris breed. My father was, you could say, a pedigree, a real pedigree. He was unlike any pedigree known to man. He was a stegosaurus, you see. His coloring was unfathomable, such vibrant colors of fuchsia, rosé, and dare I say, pink.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Your grandfather, grandma, whatever.
My father.
Your father.
Yes.
This pega, what was the name?
He was a stegosaurus, you see.
Legosaurus?
A stegosaurus.
Stegosaurus.
A stegosaurus.
Hegosaurus.
Say it with me, my darling. Steg.
Steg.
O.
O.
Saurus.
Saurus.
Steg.
Steg.
O.
O.
Saurus.
Saurus.
Stegosaurus.
Bada bada.
Anyways, this is my friend Jerry.
How you do? Wait, whoa, 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 whoa. No, it's Gianna.
Brianna.
No, Gianna.
Barbara.
Gianna.
Clara.
We've been over this 1,000 times.
Okay,
it's
Karen,
Gianna. Gianna.
Sophia.
G.
Gianna.
Gianna.
Blah, blah.
Gianna, right?
Yeah.
What? Who are you?
Oh, well, I'm a giraffe from Brooklyn Zoo. Actually, funny story. I recently got let out for good behavior last week. It's very good news. It's actually how I met Gladys. Gladys? Yeah, Gladys, she's a nice kid and all, but she's an airhead.
She's bossy, very naive, very all into herself, if you know what I mean. And she has no, absolutely no clue about science.
One eternity later.
Particular. She always walking around with her nose stuck up in the air. You know, if her nose was any higher, she'd drown when it rained. She's also stuffy to be around.
How did you guys meet again?
Oh, so funny story, actually. When we were walking down the street,
why don't you let me tell this story? Because you see, it started with me, as all things do. I was out for my evening stroll in the gardens, and I heard this atrocious noise, and so I steeled all the courage within me to go investigate. And what do I find but this creature with her head in the dumpster? And I was like, does she know that it's dirty? Like, there are germs and things in there. And my heart just went out to her, because who knows when the last time that was cleaned. And with all this corona happening, I feared for her life, you see. And so I decided to take her under my proverbial wing, so you say. And I took her straight to the vet for quarantine. And I had, let me tell you, I had her tested up and down for an assortment of ailments. You see, for many things. And I even had my servants give her a flea bath and douse her in essential oils.
Oh, those essential oils! Give me a headache for a week!
Oh, let me tell you, she smelled horrid.
Wait a second! How did you guys get in the inner courtyard?
Actually, so I was walking down the street and I saw this tree, right? And I was like, hey, I'm gonna go climb the tree. So I went to climb the tree. I hear Gladys behind me being like, don't break a leg. And I'm like, I won't break a leg. I've been doing this since I was 12. Anyway, so I'm climbing up this tree and all of a sudden I just see sky. And who knew? I'm on the third floor.
Well, that security problem has now been secured.
Do you have the time? Ah, it's high tea. Would you like to join me?
Okay.
We are having the tea. Now, Gianna, settle yourself. Pour the tea.
All right.
Gently, my dear. Gently.
Okay, okay. Gently. I got this. I can do this.
Please don't spill it on me. Good. Slowly. Good. Good. That's enough.
Tea.
That's enough. Goodness. That's enough, dear. We are all about class and boys. We do not spill a single drop, even if the tea pourer. Excuse me!
There was just a little something.
No. We do not degrade ourselves to such a level. You take your two fingers, like so. You wrap your two fingers around the teacup. You can use your third finger for support if you need it, but the important thing is to keep these two fingers, we'll call them our fancy fingers, and keep them aloft.
I feel like you only like need one finger to be aloft.
Gianna!
What?
That is not class.
I was doing what you told me, Dad. You use three fingers.
That is not class.
You have my pinky one up.
You hold the handle like a Sioux. And two fingers, Camille. Two fingers, thank you very much.
That's really
and then
hard.
You sip the
I'm pretty
tea.
Sure that's wrong.
Like a Sioux. And then, if you will, you take your biscuit. It's a lovely biscuit of the peanut butter variety. We're quarantined, so we don't have many biscuits right now. But we will make do.
Mine's kind of soggy.
Well, that is of the part of the tea pourer. You will just have to make do with that. So you take your...
It's good for your soul.
You take your... Excuse me, I'm speaking. Take your biscuit and you slosh it around. Good. Excellent. And then you may eat your biscuit. Please, don't slosh on me. Thank you. Gianna?
Yeah?
Do you like the biscuit?
I like the stirring part. It's
right.
A lot of fun.
Now you take it in your mouth and you...
I eat it?
Yes, you do. You eat it.
It's
lovely. Do you like it, Camille?
You know, I think I'll just...
Anyway, so, Gladys, you have lots of names.
I do. I have six names.
I am Gladys Fiona Rosero Laverne Hemingway Bingley III. Thank you very much.
See, that's a lot. That's twice as many as I have three names.
You have three names?
I have a first name, a middle name, and a last name.
Ah, beginning, middle, and end.
Yeah.
Correct.
No. So, none of that. You only need one name. You don't need all the five.
Oh, no. What about your family name?
Well, it's just Gianna.
Just Gianna.
Do
you
have
a family name?
I have a family name. My last, generally speaking, your last name is your family name.
No.
Or your last three names.
Passed down from your mother and father, I presume.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's the reason why. You see, I don't have that. I just got my first name. That's all I need.
I'm good. You know your parents, Gianna?
Well, you see, no.
Oh, okay. Well, that's interesting because I was just thinking about this verse just actually a few minutes ago. And it says... Our Father God, from whom the whole family in heaven and earth is named. If you believe in Jesus and receive him as your Lord, you are actually named after your Father in heaven. Did you know that?
Oh, so you mean to tell me that I could have another name added to my list?
Well, yeah, I mean, that's not really the point. The point of it, a name is who you are, right? People think of your name and they think of your identity. And they think of your family name and they think of your family identity. And so whenever you become a Christian and believe in Jesus, your new identity is the identity of your father and he gives you his name. Isn't that cool? So if you want, especially you, Gianna, since you only have one name,
If you would like to give your heart to Jesus, the way you do that is you believe in him. You believe that he died on the cross for your sins, that he rose again on the third day. He's alive and he's coming back again. And if you believe that with all of your heart and confess with your mouth, Jesus is my Lord, that means he's my owner and controller and I give my life to him, then you will be his and you will have a home in heaven and you will have a new name.
Wow. Never thought of having a new name.
Yeah.
Just kind of stuck with the one.
Uh-huh. So, would you like to pray and ask Jesus into your heart and to give you a new name?
Yeah, I think I would.
Okay. And boys and girls, if you heard that and you want to have the family name of God our Father, you pray this with me. And Gladys, you pray too if you want. Mm-hmm. Okay? Here we go. Say this. Say, Jesus.
Jesus.
I believe in you.
I believe in you.
Give me the family name.
Give me the family name.
Forgive my sins.
Forgive my sins.
And give me a home in heaven.
And give me a home in heaven.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Hey, look, I got another name.
Gianna Christian.
Gianna Christian. Mm-hmm. What do you think of that, Gladys?
I think it's a beautiful name.
I think it's great.
I think it's a beautiful name. You know what I think? I think we should celebrate. Do you know how I think we should celebrate?
I love celebrating in general.
You like celebrating?
Mm-hmm.
I think we should dance.
Oh, forget about it. Let's do it.
I dance
like no other. But you haven't seen nothing yet.
Warning you.
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. Off from my city, off from my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket. Got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it. Moving so phenomenally. You're more like the way we rock it. So don't stop.
Jeremiah, can you tell me what you're doing in the tree here?
Gladys, for the last time, my name is Gianna. How glad is not Brianna? Wish you get it through your thick little...
I believe the integrity of that limb is not going to support your entire mass.
Gladys, who's the giraffe here? It ain't you. I am perfectly fine.
Are you certain?
I don't really need your input on my tree climbing life, okay? So get your snow out of my business.
I do believe if we just take those stairs right there, we could get there a lot faster, though.
Now you tell me the stairs.
They're right behind you, dear.
You could have told me that about an hour ago.
Stairs, come on. Things I shouldn't do, but you dance, dance, dance. And ain't nobody leaving soon, so keep dancing.